said we get another 5 minutes or less. The way these overtime games have been all season long, man, there are some beautiful goals scored in overtime this
Flames
year.
Flames game in Toronto Saturday ended quickly, and yes, Huberto took a high sticking penalty right off the faceoff, yep, to start overtime, and Toronto scored on the power play. Overtime underway in Montreal. Dooley with a pass to Suzuki. Working with Anderson, bumps it back. Here's Anderson, shoots, marks from save. Rebound off the outside of the post. Rasmus Anderson with a puck. Feeds it ahead to Toffoli. He'll turn back. Things get set now. They have their first possession of OT. Flipped across. Nazem Kadri on the puck. Wheeling through center. Gains the zone. He'll slow it down. Oh. Spin around inside the line. Kadri. One more time. Circling. Feathers one through. Penalty to Toffoli. He got the stick up on Anderson. Second straight game. Flames take a high sticking penalty in overtime. And Montreal is going on the power play.
Let's take a look at this first opportunity. Watch this beautiful pass by Dooley right onto the tape of Suzuki. He drops it back, and there's a great save off Anderson. Now the puck comes back into the Canadian zone. Watch, Toffoli's going to try and lift the stick of Anderson. And he is given a penalty for high sticking. It's 4 minutes. A double minor for high sticking.
So 4-on-3 power play for essentially the remainder of overtime for Montreal. Building. Comes alive. Dvorak, Suzuki, Hoffman, Doc on the power play. Backlund, Zadorov, and Anderson out there for Calgary on the penalty kill. Montreal gets the puck off the faceoff. Doc, Suzuki. Doc feeds it over. Hoffman shoots. Blocker save. Markstrom. Hoffman brings the puck around the boards. Suzuki feeds it down low. Dvorak in ball, looking for Hoffman, just out of his reach. Doc resets just inside the line. Here's Suzuki. Kirby Doc. Mike Hoffman. Dvorak in front of Markstrom. Suzuki down low, back in front. Stop by Markstrom. Rebound. Put it wide. Another big save by Jacob Markstrom off Nick Suzuki. Here's Doc. Take his time and play it over. Suzuki on the other side now. Doc. Thought about passing to Hoffman. Back to Suzuki instead. One more time. Doc. Hoffman. One timer. And blocker saved by Markstrom. Rebound over to Suzuki. He'll switch spots with Doc. He'll try it this way now. Suzuki deflected in front by Dvorak. And Markstrom with the save, and he's able to hang on.
What goaltending, and Nick Suzuki is good anywhere, but I love him on the right flank. And watch this nice give and go with Dvorak right there. Gets it right back, and an incredible save. What an opportunity. Then Hoffman's going to get an opportunity on the one-timer. He's got such a great shot. And then lastly, watch Dvorak right in front. Another redirect. As we've mentioned a number of times tonight, Dvorak has been all around it. Just can't beat Markstrom.
Off the faceoff. Dvorak back to Doc. Same four Canadians on the power play. Doc, Suzuki. Back to the line. Dvorak in front. Suzuki over to Doc. Hoffman now. Down low to Dvorak. Trying to pull it across him. Markstrom with a poke check. Good play there by the Flames goaltender, and the loose puck's cleared all the way down the ice.
Fantastic play. Dvorak was looking for Nick Suzuki on the other side of the net, and Markstrom was all over it.
Doc flying into the zone. He'll stop on the left flank and play it back to Suzuki. Dvorak right back to the front of the goal. Here's Doc. Gets it back. Suzuki. Not about one time. He had to take it on the backhand. Here's Doc on the top of the circle. Out of the Doc. Pass across. Bounces out of the corner to Hoffman. Doc. Suzuki. One more time for Kirby Doc. Hands want a shot. Passes instead. Hoffman. Doc. Butters in behind. Hennepin around the bar. It's off the stick of Hoffman, and that'll clear all the way down the ice. Blanky to change on the PK and get it. Inside 2 minutes to go in overtime.
Oh, I can't believe the Flames got a full change. All three guys were able to get out there fresh.
That was full. Gaetan Boucher to the bench.
That's well put. One of the best speed skaters ever.
Dooley pumps it back. Second power play unit on now for Montreal. Dadonoff plays it across. Lapkovsky down the boards. Leaned on by Zadorov. They go down in the heat. Loose puck at the line. Chopped out by Backlund. Kept in by Dooley. Forced in deep. Stays on the puck. Back to the line. Slavkovsky with a shot. Pull off. It bounced off the end board to Anderson around the glass. Now get down the ice. Now Backlund chasing. Allen comes way out to play. Gets there ahead of Backlund. Steals. Allen hustles back to the net. Backlund wants the handle. Close call there for Montreal. 5 minutes of play in overtime. Canadiens still in the power play. Dadonoff will circle. Plays it across. Slavkovsky fires a pass over. It's a 2-on-1 down low. Great save. Markstrom on the knee on the erection. Puck walks up to the corner. What a stop by Jacob Markstrom. Here's Suzuki again. Slavkovsky back at the line. Markstrom's been terrific. Suzuki with a pass to Dadonoff. They bump it behind there for Suzuki. Anderson there to break it up. Taken back by Suzuki. Puck flipped around the boards. Anderson trying to get there. Tip back to the line. Slavkovsky feeds it over. Fed down low. Suzuki had to go off the heel of the stick. Here's Armia. Doesn't shoot. Now he does. Markstrom makes the save. Puck winds up in the corner. Suzuki. Here's Goff. Shoots. That was blocked. Penalty's over. Toffoli's out of the box. They killed it off. Final seconds of overtime. Dock out the other side. Tom winding down. And that'll blow out the Flames somehow. Kill off 4 minutes of four on three and push this game to a shootout. Unbelievable.
All right. This game has gone to the top of the pile for me for my favorite game this season so far. Well, we got to see Michael Backlund with an opportunity. Allen's going to race out and beat Backlund to the puck, but then the puck's going to hop right there over Gouley's stick, and Backlund, he's going to attack the net. The puck bounces on him. He can't attack. And then watch this sequence of saves by Markstrom. Best off Armia. This is just such a quality game. How about Hennepin already missing 10 out? And then lastly, another save or two by Markstrom.
Seven shots in overtime. Markstrom stops them all. 37-38 during the game. Hennepin needs some oxygen at the bench. That was a terrific overtime penalty kill by the Flames. A double minor high sticking penalty on Toffoli. 4 minutes of 4-on-3. And somehow, Kelly, they get it to a shootout.
And it's not a wasted power play by Montreal. They had tons of chances. Just better goaltending by Markstrom. So you can't really criticize the Canadiens' power play and say, they wasted that opportunity. They had every chance to score and most likely would have on a different goaltender, but Markstrom was just tremendous.
Well, he was terrific in Columbus on Friday,
yeah.
Even better tonight, and
yeah.
It looks like Jacob Markstrom has rediscovered his A game.
I agree.
And that is encouraging for Calgary
yeah.
fans.
Yeah, he reached the bottom a couple weeks ago when he said that he sucked at hockey, and he's rebuilt his game. By the way, he only let in 2 goals that game that he said that about himself, so it's not as though he was terrible, right?
It's just the first goal
he
that game
didn't
wasn't
like
a great
the first
one.
Goal,
yeah.
Right.
All right. Time for the shootout. Rem Pitlick will be the first shooter for Montreal. So Pitlick on Markstrom to start round one. Markstrom able to get a piece of that, I believe, with the shaft of the stick, and he has a couple words for Pitlick too as he skates away.
No surprise there. Watch Pitlick go to backhand and
look at
quickly to forehand. Yes. Nice play by Markstrom. Quick movement by Pitlick though.
Huberto had the goal on the power play in regulation. Now a chance in the shootout. Jonathan Huberto on Jake Allen. Scores! Sneaks at 5-hole. Just Flames draw first blood. and in the shootout.
Jonathan Huberto elects to go wide and then slows down right there. And there must not have been very much room, but it's somehow able to sneak that through 5-4.
Nick Suzuki on Markstrom. Round two. As he swings out wide. Suzuki. Scores! Markstrom got a piece of it, but Suzuki able to flip it off the glove and in.
We've seen this move before from Nick Suzuki. Markstrom was all over it. He read this play. He's mad at himself because, see that? He had the glove there. He knew what to expect. He just missed it.
Rasmus Anderson. He's good at shootouts. Swings up to the left. Anderson. Put underneath. Allen, but out the other side.
Similar move to how he scored in Florida for the game winner. He's going to go wide and continue right there, but he elevated it in Florida. This one, he just ran out of real estate and couldn't get the puck up and over the goaltender.
Round three, Kirby Dach up first for Montreal. Dach zigzagging into the zone. Scores!
Okay, that's a set of hands right there.
Wow.
Wow is right. And just take a look how quickly he gets out onto his forehand and then elevates. I mean, that's a world-class shot right there.
What do you do with that if you're a goalie?
Huh? Not much. You hope that he shoots high and wide.
Nazem Kadri. Allen can win it with a save. Kadri! Stop it! And the Canadiens come from behind and win it 2-1 in a shootout.
Kadri's going to try and open up going 5-0. He's going to go hard to his left right there. And nothing by Allen. I mean, he closed that up very, very quickly. That was a fantastic hockey game, Rick. You and I had the pleasure of calling.
Had a bit of everything. Not a ton of goals, but wow. Physical. Exciting. Great goaltending. And ultimately, a Montreal win in the shootout. The Canadiens sweep the season series. They've won five straight now against Calgary. 2-1 your final in Montreal. As we hand things back, it's time for Sportsnet Central with Kent and Martine.